infrastructure is needed to transform the data, the large amounts of data, into the trained model. Central in the whole machine learning development are the GPUs that we deploy at scale at CSCS, and each of them, every single chip, can be considered a supercomputer in its own. A key aspect of a GPU is its capability to deal with massive amounts of data and massive amounts of compute highly efficiently in a highly energy efficient way.
The first step is cleaning, curating data to make sure that it's high quality. And this helps us avoid using precious energy and GPU cycles on low quality data that's not likely to make the model train well. This is the data efficiency aspect. There's also the model efficiency and the system infrastructure efficiency.
Such a big supercomputer you can somehow imagine as being a Formula One car. And we know how to drive it for a race of, you know, a few hours, but now we had actually to race for many months in a row. And so keeping the performance stable over such a prolonged period was a really interesting challenge. And of course, it's important to have an engineering team that supports you on that challenge.
It is much more efficient to train these kind of large models in facilities like the Alps supercomputer in CSCS. The CSCS facility is sourcing all of its electricity from hydropower, and it's carbon neutral. The way that power is delivered to the actual servers is highly optimized, as well as the cooling, etc. And we're also leveraging cutting-edge hardware and features of these GPUs that are designed to efficiently train these models, as well as software infrastructure on top. Having a model open source as opposed to a kind of closed source or just open weights model is truly a game changer for the kinds of innovation that we can do as a scientific community. This enables you to reproduce this and build on top of it in all kinds of ways, and enables all kinds of use cases that maybe even the original team of people who trained the model, you know, might not have even imagined.
Developing this model on a scientific supercomputer actually is very important to give this trustworthy and reliable, some investigatable large language model to the whole public.